وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد وإن شرح في الكتاب نزهة النظر في توضيح نخبة الفكر للحافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله تعالى للحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله تعالى We finished the first type of hadiths which are rejected from the types that we were speaking about, the 10 types of at-ta'an or criticism. صح? We spoke about the first one, which is al-mawdu'. And we explained that the mawdu' means هُوَ الطَّعْنُ بِكَذِبِ الرَّاوِيِّ فِي الْحَدِيثِ النَّبَوِيِّ That when the narrator is criticized for lying, he's what? He's critiqued and he's criticized for lying about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we spoke about the severity of this particular issue, which is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, مَنْ سَبَقْ مَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ مُتَعَمِّدًا فَلِيَتَبَوَّأْ مَقْعَدَهُ مِنَ النَّارِ Anyone who lies about me deliberately, who says that which I haven't said, let him prepare his place in the hellfire. And we also spoke about, in our last lesson, on this particular point, we spoke about where and how we can identify when a hadith is mawdu', the qara'in, التي يدرك بها الوضع, the external factors that can allow us to know that this hadith is what? Is mawdu'. External factors that can allow us to identify and recognize that a what? That a hadith is mawdu'. And I also gave examples of wad', fabrication being done. I also spoke about what causes a person to do wad'. Why would a person actually fall into fabricating a hadith? I mentioned imma adamuddin, the person has no religious ethics. So zanadiqa, the heretics. So they'll lie about the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Or ghalabatul jahli, they're excessively ignorant. Kaba'd al-muta'abbidin, like some of the worshippers who did not know the Prophet's ahadith, so they will just make up ahadiths. They will lie. Or fardul asabiyyah. Or these people, what do they have? They are very fanatic individuals. So there is a particular madhab that they blind follow. So they have to make ahadith to support their madhab. Kaba'd al-muqallideen. Sometimes the madhab says a statement and they can't find the evidence for it. So they'll lie, some of them. This is what makes them do it. أو اتباعي هوا, or the person is following desires. Like بعض الرؤساء, like some of the leaders. That's what they want. They're following desires, so they'll make ahadiths and fabricate ahadiths in favor of themselves. أو الإغراب لقصد الاشتهار, or the person will do it with the intent of wanting to become famous, so they can be people who can know who they are and understand who they are. So that's what they do. What do? They want to be famous and say, oh, this hadith is unique. It can only be found with fulan and fulan. So that's what he wants. So that's why he would lie. And we mentioned, we spoke about that particular issue. We spoke about also the ruling of lying about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We all said that scholars, by unanimous decision, they've all agreed that it's a, what? It's haram. And this is haram bi ijma'. And this is, as Ibn Hajar mentioned, it is haram bi ijma'i man yu'taddu bihi. It's haram on those whose consent is taken on board. And as for the Ahlul Bid'ah, can Ahlul Bid'ah, their difference of opinion, can it do kharqul ijma'? Can it pierce through the ijma'? Can the statements of the Ahlul Bid'ah, can it pierce through ijma'? No, not at all. That's what Hafiz ibn Hajar said, وَكُلُّ ذَلِكَ حَرَامٌ بِإِجْمَاعِ مَنْ يُعْتَدُّ بِهِ إِلَّا أَنَّ بَعْضَ الْكَرَّامِيَّةِ Except what? The Karramiyyah. The Karramiyyah are who? أتباع محمد ibn Karram. They are followers of Muhammad ibn Karram, a deviated group. And if you look at the Asha'ira today, they are Karramiyyah. the usul is the usul of the Karramiyyah, except the only things is that the Karramiyyah didn't become as famous as the Asha'ira became famous. There are slight differences here and there, but asal is that they're very, very, very roughly the same. Now, inshallah ta'ala, without any further ado, we're going to go into the second type of ahadith which are critiqued and criticized. وَالْقِسْمُ الثَّانِي وَالثَّانِي meaning, وَالثَّانِي here means أي وَالْقِسْمُ الثَّانِي the second type. مِنْ أَقْسَامِ الْمَرْدُودِ from the ahadith which are rejected. It is الْمَتْرُوكِ. Matruk is what, brothers? Matruk is مَا يَكُونُ بِالسَّبَبِ تُهْمَةُ الرَّاوِيِّ بِالْكَدِبِ. This individual is suspected of lying. Suspicion of lying. This is the second one. This hadith is called what? The hadith that are narrated by an individual who is muttahamun bil kadib, who is suspected of lying, is called matruk. What is it called? Matruk. I already mentioned before, as Hafiz al-Hajjal mentions, that the one who is muttahamun bil kadib, the one who is suspected of lying, it is that بِأَلَّا يُرْوَى ذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثِ إِلَّا مِنْ جِهَدِهِ. How can we... What does it mean, مُتَهَمٌ بِالْكَدِبِ? This person is suspected of lying. It means this hadith is not narrated from anyone other than him. بِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثُ لَا يُرْوَى إِلَّا مِنْ جِهَدِهِ. This hadith, we can't find it. It is not narrated except from his direction. وَيَكُونُ And it is also what? مُخَالِفًا لِلْقَوَاعِدِ الْمَعْلُومَةِ. And it is also in a position to the well-grounded principles in the Sharia. وَكَذَا مَنْ عُرِفَ بِالْكَذِبِ فِي كَلَامِي. And also anybody who in his day-to-day life he's known to lie. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَظْهَرْ مِنْهُ وُقُوعُ ذَلِكَ فِي الْحَدِيثِ النَّبَوِي وَهَذَا دُونَ الْأَوَّلِي. Even if he's not known to lie about the Prophet, there's no clear-cut statement of his in which he directly lies about the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. But what we do have is him lying on his normal day-to-day matters. This person is called what? متهم بالكذب. So what did Hafiz al-Hajjal mention? He mentioned three things. Number one is that this individual narrates things that no one else narrates except him. He comes with strange things. Number two, what he says actually goes against the principles of the Sharia. He goes against it. Okay? And number three is that he is known to lie on his day-to-day basis. What is he known to lie on? He lies on his day-to-day discussions. He's known to lie up on it. But we've never seen him lie about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This person is called mutamun bil kadib. His ahadith are what? Matruk. They're rejected. They're what? They're rejected. وَالثَّالِثُ The third type. وَالثَّالِثُ is al-munkaru ala ra'yin. وَالثَّالِثُ The third one is al-munkaru ala ra'yin. It is munkar according to an opinion. Which third one is he talking about? He's talking about al-mukhalafa, right? If I'm not wrong. وَتُوَمَتُوا بِذَلِكَ أَوْ فُحْشُ غَلَطِهِ. The third one, which is فُحْشُ غَلَطِهِ, that's the third one, right? Or فُحْشُ غَلَطِهِ, that's munkar. That's it. What? Why did he say عَلَى رَأْيٍ? Why did Hafiz ibn Hajar say وَفُحْشُ غَلَطِهِ is munkar عَلَى رَأْيٍ? Hey, who can answer that? We took, remember before, that the munkar is مُخَالَفَةُ الضَّعِيفِ is when a weak individual opposes and he goes against what? A weak person goes against what? Arwat al-thiqat, the reliable individuals. صح? We did take that, didn't we take that? So that was another opinion what munkar means. Shad meant what? Mukhalafat al-thiqa is when a reliable person opposes another reliable person, this is called shad. But when a weak person opposes reliable people, people of integrity, this is called munkar. That was one opinion. And here, فُحْشُ غَلَطِهِ is also munkar as well, عَلَى رَأْيٍ according to another opinion. And now we learn that the munkar can be is being used for both. That's why he says, الْمُنْكَرُ عَلَى رَأْيٍ. Like in what is most known as munkar, very well known to be a hadith which is munkar, is ma khalaf fihi al-rawi al-da'if. It is that the weak narrator, he opposes arwat al-thiqat. He opposes the reliable, honorable scholars of hadith. He opposes them. He opposes them. وَكَذَا الرَّابِعُ وَالْخَامِسُ. What is the khamis and the rabi' and the khamis? كَثْرَةُ غَفْلَتِهِ أو فِسْ أو ظهر أو ظهور فِسْقَتِهِ صح فِسْقِهِ أو فِسْقِهِ صح غَفْلَتِهِ صح أو فِسْقِهِ. What does غَفْلَتِهِ means? What does it actually mean that the person is a person who has غَفْلَة? A غَفْلَة means a person who doesn't have إِتْقَان. He doesn't have itqan, meaning he's not precise, he's not accurate. Any narrations that aren't his narrations, if somebody says to him, these are your narrations, you told me, he doesn't know it, he'll just say, okay. He will accept talqeen. He's not a precise person. Sah? Remember when Abu Na'im Fadl ibn Dukayn was tested by Yahya ibn Ma'in? We were together. And he tried to test him to see his memory. So he asked him a hadith that were not his, and a hadith that were his, just to see if he's going to know which one from which. And did Abu Na'im Fadl ibn Dukayn, did he know it? So he has what? Itqan. It's precise. Every hadith that he's narrated is like, these are my riwayat. He knows them. As for the other one who's heedless, who's ghafil, is absent-minded, he'll accept everything. He will what? Accept everything. وَلِذَلِكَ what did we say the precision is? The ضَبْط is how many times? ضَبْضُ الصَّدْرِ and ضَبْضُ الكتابة. So what is it? ضبط الصدر. His memory means that if a person tells him from the top of their memory, this hadith is yours, because of his hifz, he can reject and say, no, this is not my hadith. Who told you this? I haven't read narrated this. Are we together? And ضبط الكتابة means that his book, anything that gets put in it, he can realize it. He's got itqan, he's not ghafil. No one can just play around with his book. He knows his book inside out. He doesn't know, if he speaks from the top of his mind, he doesn't know anything. But when he takes his book, he's mutqid, he's grounded in it. Are we all together? He also shouldn't be heedless where anybody can assert anything into his book. Are we all together? This is what? This is the fourth type. أو فسقه. Fisq means a person comes with fusuq. And fusuq is a person does major sins. Either they do it by speech or action, as long as it doesn't reach kufr. Are we all together? Remember, we do not condition like the Rafidah alayhi min Allahi ma yastahiqoon. We don't condition like the Rafidah condition isma, that the leaders and the scholars and the people who narrate a hadith, they have to all be what? Ma'asum. They have to be infallible. Rather, we believe nobody is infallible in this ummah after Nabiullah Muhammad. Are we all together? Like, what do these people believe? They believe ismatul a'imma. The Rafidah, they believe that the a'imma are ma'sumin. They are infallible. They don't do mistakes. They don't even do mistakes in their worldly affairs. So they believe. They don't forget something. They don't. They believe isma, they believe they are infallible. Sahwa. So when a Rafidi comes up to you and tells you mistakes of the companions, you as Ahlul Sunnah, a Sunni, you're not in any problem because you believe that the companions are not ma'sumin. The companions are what? They are not infallible. The companions are not infallible. But you Rafidi prove that they're in the hellfire and they're kuffar. But we believe they don't have, they're not infallible. But the Shaykh al-Islam Taymi actually said, he said, Rahimahullah ta'ala, لَيْسَ مِنْ شَرْطِ الْوِلَايَةِ الْعِصْمَةِ. It is not condition, it's not from the conditions of being a wali to be infallible. Nobody would be a wali then. Nobody would be a wali. So it's not a condition. Like, what we're saying is that if the person is doing major sins, this is different now. This is a criticism against them. Or if the person is doing the minor sins bil israr, he's doing the minor sins with continuation. He's persisting and he's continuously carrying on the minor sins. This is also a problem. And the fisq, it can happen by two ways. Here we're not talking about the other type of fisq, which is fisq bil mu'taqad, which is bid'ah or anything. Are we together? Here we're talking about fisq amali. Here when he says, oh fisqihi, he means fisq by actions, what we would call ma'asi, sins. Amma fisq al mu'taqad, that's bid'ah, we'll come to that. We'll come to that, inshallah, soon. He's going to mention that bid'ah or bid'atihi. But remember we mentioned last time, he took kadhib out of this place. What did he do? He took lying out of this. And we mentioned the reason why he did that. So the four or five are also, so number three, number four, and number five, what are they called? Munkar. So the narration that comes through what? أو فحش غلطه أو غفلته أو فسقه. What is that all called? What is it called? It's actually called Munkar. It's called what? It's called Munkar. ثم الوهم إن طلع عليه بالقرائن وجمع الطرق فالمعلل. Now we move on to number six. Number six, قسم السادس, the sixth type, which is what? ثم الوهم. Remember we mentioned the sixth one was what? Al-wahmu. Wahmu is what? Wahm is when the person is delusional. That is what wahm means. Is when he narrates something ala sabil al-tawahhumi. When he narrates something out of what? Thinking that this is what it is. And we said that the root word is from wahima wahman. Good. It's the sixth type. If the external factors are looked at, as Ibn Hajar mentions, he says, وَإِنِ اطُّلِعَ عَلَيْهِ بِالْقَرَائِنِ. After looking at the external indications that are there, وَجَمْعِ الطُّرُقِ, and the chains are brought together, and a person stands over it, فَالْمُعَلَّلُ. This is called hadith, which is mu'allala. Pay attention here, brothers. Okay? Wahm, can it occur from a thiqah? Can. And this is the type which is hardest. To come across that an imam, thiqah, mutqin, than wahm. Wahm means when he thinks this is what it is. Slip of the tongue or anything like that. It falls under wahm. It's to think that this is what it is and then realize, oh, sorry. Sah? Are we all together? It's like somebody seeing Sa'ad and thinking he's Imran's brother. But they know Imran. So, Assalamu alaikum, everything. Hey, Imran, when are you going to... I said, no, I'm Imran's brother. Mathalan, wahima. But he doesn't mix up with other people. He knows everyone around him. Sah? Are we together? Wahm is what we say. How can you actually identify an imam who's grounded, his precision, his accuracy, and mashallah. But guess what? He has done wahm in a particular narration. He's done wahm in a particular situation. How would you identify that? This you'd have to come with what? In الطلع عليه بالقرائن. You'd have to look at external factors. You would have to bring all of the narrations together. And then you'd find there's a defect here. ولذلك, this is one of the hardest, is one of the hardest types of, is one of the hardest types of hadith. It's one of the types that are most hardest ahadiths. How would that happen? Sometimes with the wahm occurs by what? Wasl mursalin. He will make a hadith which is mursal, he'll do wasl of it, he'll connect it to the Prophet. Or a hadith which is munqati', he'll connect it. Or he would emerge two ahadiths into each other. Or other than that, this is a criticism on the narrator now. He gets critiqued for that. How could you know this hadith there's a wahm in it? Hafiz told you. He told you by jam'u turuqi. You have to bring all of the turuq together, all of the riwayat together. Look what he says. Look at what he says in Nusratul Nazar. He says, وَهُوَ مِنْ أَغْمَضِ أَنْوَاعِ الْعُلُومِ الْحَدِيثِ وَأَدَقِّهَا. That this type, which is ahadith which are mu'allal, the ahadith which have defects, he said, وَهُوَ مِنْ أَغْمَضِ أَنْوَاعِ عُلُومِ الْحَدِيثِ وَأَدَقِّهَا. This is one of the most أغْمَضِ, the most ambiguous, okay, types of ahadith, and it is the most detailed ones. وَلَا يَقُومُ بِهِ إِلَّا مَنْ رَزَقَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فَهْمًا ثَاقِبًا. And no one can stand up for it except the person who Allah has given them what? A very precise understanding. وَحِفْظًا وَاسِعًا. Allah has given that person a vast memorization. وَمَعْرِفَةً تَامَّةً بِمَرَاتِبِ الرُّوَاتِ. And Allah has also given them the ability to know the levels of the narrators. وَمَلَكَةٌ قَوِيَّةٌ بِالْأَسَانِيدِ وَالْمُتُونِ. And this person also has what? They have malaka. Malaka is this innate ability that is strong in the chain and the wordings of the Prophet. وَلِهَذَا لَمْ يَتَكَلَّمْ فِيهِ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ هَذِي الشَّأْنِ. And many of the people haven't spoken about this particular issue. Not many have. Only a handful of them spoke about them. كعلي بن المديني وأحمد بن حنبل والبخاري ويعقوب بن أبي شيبة وأبي حاتم وأبي زرعة ودارقطني. These are the people who spoke about it. Not everybody can speak about it. وقد تقصر عبارة المعلل عن إقامة الحجة على دعواه كالصيرفي في نقد الدينار والدرهم. Sometimes Hafiz mentions وقد تقصر عبارة المعلل عن إقامة الحجة عن دعوة. Sometimes علي بن مدينة أحمد البخاري يعقوب بن أبي شيبة أبي حاتم الرازي أبو زرعة الرازي دار قطني. Sometimes they would actually critique a hadith and say this hadith is defect, and they will not mention a proof for it. They won't. And even if you ask دار قطني himself, he can't tell you it. When he did say that, he says وقد تقصر عبارة المعلل. This Imam who done the ta'lil of the hadith and weakened it. An iqamat al-hujjati, it is absent from any proofs. Ala da'wahu, in that which he claimed. Like a person who works at a shop who knows gold from when it's false. Are we together? He can tell you that this gold is not real gold. How does he know? This is an innate ability Allah has built in him. كَالصَّيْرَفِيِّ فِي نَقْدِ الدِّينَارِ وَالدِّرْهَمِ. He has that ability. That's the power Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave these scholars. Why? Because they lived with the Prophet's hadith. They even know when the Prophet speaks the way he speaks, they start picking that up. What is it that the Prophet would say? What would he not say? They learned him, salawatullahi wa ta'ala. They lived with him. They lived with him. And his statements can come from him like that, alayhi salatu wasalam. Just like if somebody tells you a person you know did this, you're like, no. Hard for me to believe this. Wallahi, this is hard. I lived with this person under the same roof for 20 years. 20 years I've been living with them. Sah? I know this person. I know what's possible and what isn't. So this is a very powerful statement. Then a hadith, when it comes to the science of hadith, the hardest, the greatest, the most powerfulest field of hadith is what? The ilal. The defects, that's the hardest part. Hafiz mentions it to you. It's the aghmad and the adaq. It's the most hardest, the most detailed. It requires a person who hafiz. Look at that. Who has Allah given? وَلَا يَقُومُ بِهِ إِلَّا مَنْ رَزَقَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فَهْمًا ثَاقِبًا وَحِفْظًا وَاسِعًا وَمَعْرِفَةً تَامَّةً بِمَرَاتِبِ الرُّوَاتِ وَمَلَكَةً قَوِيَّةً بِالْأَسَانِيدِ وَالْمُتُونِ وَلِهَذَا لَمْ يَتَكَلَّمْ فِيهِ إِلَّا الْقَلِيلُ مِنْ أَهْلِ هَذِهِ الشَّأْنِ. حتى الشافعي doesn't speak about these issues. الإمام الشافعي مع مكانته ودرايته وعلمه. This is not what his field was about. This is specific for people. Are we all together? Everybody spoke about this. Not everybody had the ability to do this. Ali ibn al-Madini and Ahmed al-Bukhari and Yaqub ibn Abi Shayba and Abi Hatim and Abi Zura'a and Adara Qutni. A couple of days before I did a mistake, Sabqul Lisan. A mistake occurred for me. I had said that AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi said, Ya Ahla Baghdad, the people of Baghdad, that whilst I'm alive, there's nobody who can lie about the Prophet. And it wasn't him, it's Imam Darqutni who said that. The correct one is that Darqutni said this. And Imam Darqutni said, Ya Ahla Baghdad, or the people of Baghdad, no one can lie about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa ana bayna adhhurikum. Why else am I amongst you? Don't worry. Because he reached that level to know the lies of the liars, and when they lie and what they say. He lived for it, alayhi salam. He lived for it, rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Imam Ad-Darqutni. ولذلك one of the amazing things about Darqutni rahimahullah and all these a'imma is that Darqutni ala sabil al-tamthil, for as an example, he wrote his kitab al-'ilal al-warida from the top of his head. That big book that you see is 30 volumes or 25 volumes. He wrote it min hifdhi, he wrote it from his memory. Where he talks about the hardest field of 'ilal, 'ilal al-ruwat, the narrators and the defects. Darqutni wrote that from his memory, imagine that. He talks about a hadith, which this is the field of ilal, which is the hardest. And that person who's speaking about it has to have what? What Hafidh ibn Hajar mentioned. He has to be a person what? مَنْ رَزَقُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فَهْمًا ثَاقِيبًا وَحِفْظًا وَاسِعًا وَمَعْرِفَةً تَامًا بِمَرَاتِبِ الرُّوَاتِ وَمَلَكَةً قَوِيَةً بِالْأَسَانِيدِ وَالْمُتُونِ. All of that he did it. And he wrote it down. He documented it, رحمه الله تعالى. ولذلك, his book is one of the best books. His book is one of the best books that are written in this particular field. Now we go into the seventh type. ثُمَّ الْمُخَالَفَةُ. Now we're going to go into the seventh type. أو مُخَالَفَتِهِ. مُخَالَفَة. What does مُخَالَفَة mean? مُخَالَفَة means when a person opposes مُخَالَفَةُ الثِّقَةِ, the opposition of the narrators who are reliable. This person, he's opposing the ثِقَات. He's opposing the what? Those who are reliable and of great station. Hafidh ibn Hajar now talks about, he says, ثُمَّ الْمُخَالَفَةُ, if the opposition, okay, is إِنْ كَانَتْ بِتَغْيِيرِ السِّيَاقِ, it is due to the changing of the siyaq. Siyaq here means the slant, the chain. Here, إِنْ كَانَتْ بِتَغْيِيرِ السِّيَاقِ, if it's due to the changing of this chain, then this is what? فَمُدْرَجُ الْإِسْنَادِ. This is called مُدْرَجُ الْإِسْنَادِ. Are we all together? So if it is due to the changing of the chain, and the opposition is due to the changing of the chain, then this is called mudrajul isnad. This is called what? It's called mudrajul isnad. Hafidh al-Hajar mentions the mudrajul isnad, it is four types. He mentions there are four types of mudrajul isnad. The first of it being an yarwiya jama'atun al-haditha. A group of scholars will narrate a hadith bi asanida mukhtalifa. They will narrate it in different chains. فَيَرْوِيهِ عَنْهُمْ رَاوٍ. Then a narrator will narrate it from them. فَيَجْمَعُ الْكُلَّ عَلَى إِسْنَادٍ وَاحِدٍ مِنْ تِلْكَ الْأَسَانِيدِ. And what he does is that all those narrators that he narrated it from, he takes all of their narration and he makes it into one. This one who's narrating it. وَلَا يُبَيُّنُ الْإِخْتِلَافِ. And he doesn't mention they're different. That this is Fulan's chain that I took it from, and this is Fulan's chain that I took it from, and this is Fulan's chain that I took it from. He doesn't do that. What he does is that he brings all of the chain into one, without having to distinguish between one from the other. This is the first type of mudrajul isnadi. The second one is an yakuna al-matnu 'inda rawin. The hadith has a matan, has a wording of the Prophet, and it's with a particular narrator. Okay? It's with a narrator, except a tarafa minhu, except a part of it. فَإِنَّهُ عِنْدَهُ بِإِسْنَادٍ آخَرٍ. Pay attention. This hadith has what? What does this particular hadith have? This hadith has, he took this matan, this wording from a narrator, but there's a part of it that's not in the what? It's not in it for him, in that person's narration. It's in that person's narration for him. So what does he do? فَيَرْوِيهِ رَاوٍ عَنْهُ تَامًا بِالْإِسْنَادِ الْأَوَّلِ. He will take it from that narration and he would put it in that person's narration that he narrated it from. So it will look like he narrated all of it from him. And that isn't the case. He narrated part of it from this person and part of it from this person. Number three is that أَنْ يَكُونَ عِنْدَ الرَّاوِيُّ مَتْنَانِ مُخْتَلِفَانِ بِإِسْنَادَيْنِ مُخْتَلِفَيْنِ فَيَرْوِيهِمَا رَاوٍ عَنْهُ مُقْتَصِلًا عَلَىٰ أَحَدِ الْإِسْنَادَيْنِ. It is أَنْ يَكُونَ عِنْدَ الرَّاوِيُّ, with a narrator, there are two matan, two wordings. مُخْتَلِفَانِ, they're both different. بِإِسْنَادَيْنِ, with two different chains that are different. So the two weddings, and each chain is different from the other chain of the hadith. فَيَرْوِيهِمَا He then narrates them rawin, a narrator anhu مُخْتَصِرًا, by sufficing and restricting himself on that. عَلَىٰ أَحَدِ الْإِسْنَادَيْنِ, with one of those chains, he will do that. But then what would he do? لَكِنْ يَزِيدُ فِيهِ مِنَ الْمَتْنِ الْآخَرِ مَا لَيْسَ فِي الْمَتْنِ الْأَوَّلِ. So he'd add on to that which isn't in the second one, he would add it extra into the first one. And last one, what he mentions, أَنْ يَسُوقَ الرَّاوِيُّ الْإِسْنَادِ فَيَعْرِضُ لَوْ عَارِضٌ فَيَقُولُ كَلَامًا مِنْ قِبَلِ نَفْسِهِ فَيَظُنُّ بَعْضُ مَنْ سَمِعَهُ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ الْكَلَامُ وَمَتْنُ ذَلِكَ الْإِسْنَادِ فَيَرْوِيهِ عَنْهُ كَذَلِكَ. The fourth one is, the person is narrating the hadith, and as he's narrating the hadith and he's mentioning the chain, something comes to his mind, a idea comes to his mind, and he mentions something, and then he comes back to the narration that he was speaking about. And so the people who are writing it think that he was what? They think that he was speaking about the chain, so it gets written inside there. That's the four types of mudrajul isnad. Hafiz mentions it for you. Go to the kitab, the Nusatun Nadar. He mentions it there for you. Then he mentions another type called mudrajul matni, which is the second type. Hafiz mentions it to you for you. أو بدمج موقوف بمرفوع فمدرجو المتني. The second type of mudraj is what? What's the second type of mudraj? Is mudraj al-matni. What does mudraj al-matni mean? Half mentions it to you in Nukhbatul-Fikr. He mentions it to you in the Nukhbatul-Fikr. What does he say? بِدَمْجِ مَوْقُوفٍ بِمَرْفُوعٍ. Damj means what? When it mixes. What mixes? What mixes? You emerge. Damj actually means to emerge, to bring into each other a mawquf with a marfu'. A marfu' with a mawquf. The speech of a sahabi becomes the speech of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This is called mudrajul matni. It's called mudrajul matni. ولذلك a great scholar, Khatib al-Baghdadi, he wrote a book where he called it al-fasl lil-wusuli المدرج في النقل الفصل للوصل sorry المدرج في النقل is called الفصل للوصل المدرج في النقل which is الحمد لله مطبوع متداول it's published and you can find it and حافظ ابن حجر he summarized the book he called it تقريب المنهج بترتيب المدرج who did it حافظ ابن حجر He summarized the book of Khatib al-Baghdadi and he called it Taqrib al-Manhaj bi-Tartib al-Mudraj. He summarized it. And his one also got summarized as well. Ibn Hajar's one, it got summarized by Al-Imam Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. He summarized it in the book Al-Mudraj ila al-Mudraj. Al-Madraj ila al-Mudraj. What did Suyuti call his one? He called it Al-Madraj ila al-Mudraj. Which is matbu' as well, is published. It is what? It is published. Na'am. We'll stop there, inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I've said that was wrong or incorrect from inshaAllah, Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.